Hello everyone, this is Direwolf20, and welcome to episode 9 of Direwolf20's Let's Play series, season 6. Hanging out, getting ready to complement the sorting system that I made last episode. So let's go a quick recap of what we've got going on. I'm going to just jump through this hole. Hooray. I've got some pipes that get pulled out of what's going to be my input chest. And they're item ducts from Thermal Expansion that are going to come in here. Anything that's an ore, like iron, gold, etc., is going to wind up being filtered into this chest. Anything otherwise is going to be sent along down to this chest, which may wind up getting upgraded. Once that filtering is complete, we're going to wind up pulling everything out of this chest, which is going to be like a middle ground sorting chest. And it's going to wind up sending everything up to the actual chests above this slot. So up above here, we're going to see a bunch of items getting filtered straight up. All right, and then anything that was an ore will wind up getting thrown into the pulverizers and redstone furnaces down here. I do need to upgrade my energy conduits because I've got more machines than this cable can handle. This guy can only transmit 80 redstone flux per tick, and these guys can drain more than 80 combined. So if I have multiple ores getting processed, the machine starts slowing down. So we definitely want to upgrade that feature. Okay. Then what else have we got here? We've got this hardened energy cell here providing power. We also need to start getting some energy sent from our steam dynamos straight over to that guy. So that's going to happen. And then finally, at the end of the day, we're going to talk about getting all the sorting done. So why don't I get the items I'm going to need to start sorting into the chests up here, and then we can kind of give this thing a little bit of a test run. I think that sounds like a good plan. So I'll be back in a few minutes once I've got my inventory cleaned out of all the junk that I've got, and then set up with everything that I'm going to need to get started, and I'll be right back. All right, so let's get started with some stuff. First off, we're going to need transfer pipes. These are the pipes that are responsible for transferring items around the world. In order to get this going, we're going to need a bit of redstone and some glass and some smooth stone. So these pipes are pretty simple and straightforward. Basically, they connect two straightforward systems. There's not much customization you can do with these basic simple pipes, so that's why they're pretty cheap. Okay, the other item we're going to need is a transfer node. This is going to be the one piece of the pipe that's responsible for pulling an item out of an inventory and inserting it into the piping network. And for this, it's crafted like so. Yoink. So we've got those guys going, okay? So transfer nodes and transfer pipes, ready to roll. All right, so in order for this to work, it's really pretty simple. Like I said, it kind of works similar to the way a hopper would work. Now, there's only one other thing we'd like to make, and that would be sorting pipes, okay? Sorting pipes are crafted like so. So I'm going to need a piece of gold, and I'm going to need another set of stone slabs. Sorting pipes are going to be very useful, because what a sorting pipe does is, where normal transfer pipes will just kind of put items into inventories, sorting pipes will put them in an inventory only if the item that you're trying to insert into that inventory already exists, or if the inventory is empty, okay? So let's take a look. I'm gonna show you a couple different examples of the way this works, and then we're gonna implement it in our system. The one other thing I'm gonna make, and that's again from Extra Utilities, so let's go find it here. I want to craft this item right here, the portable scanner. Oh, I need an Eye of Ender, really? Oh, I really wanna make a portable scanner, but I don't have the ingredients for it. Should I run to the Nether real quick and get some blaze rods? Hold on, I have an idea. Portable scanner, Eye of Ender, blaze powder. Crafting recipe for blaze powder is, there's a way to make blaze powder. Nice, with a fluid transposer and destabilized redstone. I think I might do this instead of running to the Nether. All right, I need to make these machines anyway, so we're going to take a brief break, and then we're going to make a couple different new machines from Thermal Expansion time again. Let's get ourselves something cool from Thermal Expansion. All right, so there's a couple things we're going to need to make here, guys. First off, we're going to need to make a magma crucible. So we're going to need a pair of machine blocks, because I know I'm going to need another machine after this. And then I'm also going to need a couple of redstone reception coils, again, because I know a machine's coming next. The magma crucible right here, and then another bucket ready to make for the liquid transposer. Okay, fluid transposer, I guess it's called now. There we go. So these two machines work in tandem, typically. The magma crucible, boom. And then the fluid transposer here. I'm going to set these guys up so that the output for this guy is on the right and the input for the fluid transposer is on the left. Don't forget, you're going to need a little bit of power. There we go. Power should be flowing in perfectly. Cool. All right, so let's get this guy rolling. All right, the magma crucible is able to melt down a lot of stuff. You're able to melt cobblestone, obsidian into lava. You're also able to melt down liquefacted coal, resonant ender, more lava, some water. You're also getting energized glowstone from this machine, destabilized redstone, gelid cryothium, which I'll get into later, blazing pyrothium, lots of cool stuff that you can do. So basically that's what this machine's all about, energized glowstone, lots of different options for stuff you can melt. What we're going to do is I wanted to make blaze powder. Okay, there happens to be a recipe for blaze powder in that if you infuse 200 millibuckets of destabilized redstone into glowstone dust, you'll get a blaze powder, okay? So destabilized redstone comes from 100 millibuckets per redstone dust. So we're going to throw into the magma crucible 1-2 redstone dust. That's going to make destabilized redstone. It's going to melt it down. It's going to automatically be ejected out the orange side of the block into this machine, into its blue side of the block. We've got 200 millibuckets of destabilized redstone in our fluid transposer. Fluid transposers basically can be used for two things. One, they can inject fluid into items. And two, they can be used to fill all sorts of liquid options. So if we take a look here by clicking on our recipes button, you see you can insert pretty much anything into buckets if you want. So, you know, different stuff here you can put into buckets. You can also fill up all kinds of other stuff. You can also craft mossy cobblestone bricks and a couple other nifty gadgets using this fluid transposer. All right, lots of functions available with the fluid transposer. 293 pages of recipes, quite a few things available. What we're going to inject today is some destabilized redstone into our glowstone dust. Hooray, blaze powder. That's what I was looking to get. And hopefully I've still got an ender pearl over here. I do. And then portable scanner, needed a redstone dust and some iron. Beautiful. Combine these two together, gets me an eye of ender, portable scanner, ready to go. Nice. Portable scanner is going to help you whenever you're working with these transfer pipes because it helps to show where items are traversing in the pipes. These pipes do not render items traveling through them, so it can be tricky to see where stuff's going. So let me get a chest or two, and we're going to do a little example of how these pipes work, just so you have an idea of how these things are going to flow. And then when we're ready next, I'll start adding this to the sorting system. So first off, what's required is a transfer node and some transfer pipes, and that should be good for now, okay? So the way this works is you hook up a transfer node to the inventory that you want to pull items out of, okay? You'll see that it'll start filling up its own little internal buffer from the first item in the inventory, okay? So the dirt's getting stored in the internal buffer. Now it's searching along the line of pipes for any inventories that it can insert this dirt into, anything that's going to accept dirt. If I place a pipe down, it's going to search along that path. So along the X path, or this direction, plus one, it's searching along and trying to find an inventory to insert stuff into. Failing to find it, it's just going to continue searching, okay? Now, if we have it connected to this guy right here, we'll see the dirt made its way over, as is the glass. When we have the portable scanner in our hold, we can see little redstone sparkles indicating items traveling through the pipe, okay? So that's what we've got going on. Nifty, right? Now, we're going to break this thing here, and we're going to move this glass over to here. Oh well, as the dirt, okay? What I'm going to do is insert some glass into this chest. Now, glass goes into the chest, okay? And then we're going to put a sorting pipe right there. What that's going to do is it's going to allow any glass that gets sent into here to go into this chest. Because the sorting pipe says if the item already exists in the chest, the glass, then it's going to allow the transfer node to dump it in there. Notice how the dirt's not going into the chest. That's because there is no dirt already in the chest. It can't find its way in there. It needs to find somewhere else to go. What I'm going to do is attach a transfer pipe to this chest. Cool. The dirt will find its way there pretty quickly. Now we're going to start dumping out glass. Where's the glass going to go? It's going to go to the first available inventory. Like the item ducts, the first available inventory is going to be this chest. So because there's already glass in the chest, it's going to find it and it's going to go to the first available inventory. It will always land here. See? Well, looks like we might be out of glass, so let's get a little bit more just to demonstrate. There it goes. So it's making its way into that place. So it does take a little while for it to pathfind. It runs, you know, maybe one or two blocks a second, maybe, so it's a little bit slow to find its way around, okay? When we've got the dirt that's looking for a home to go to, you know, it takes a little bit longer even to pathfind around. There it goes. It finally found a spot, and got its way in there. We can increase this, which we might actually wind up doing. So basically what we're going to do is we're going to use the transfer node here, and we're going to run some pipes up the wall. Now here's the thing I didn't tell you about. What happens when it hits an intersection? Okay, basically an intersection, it's going to randomly choose a path. And it's going to, for example, maybe find its way down here. And if it doesn't find anywhere to put the inventory, it's going to reset and work its way back up to the top here. Okay, so let's give that just a quick demonstration to show you guys what happens. Okay, I'm going to throw a bunch of glass in there. Let's see what happens. Okay, so you can see it's heading down there. Okay, it didn't find anywhere to go. So it starts again at the beginning and randomly chooses. It happened to choose the chest that time. It happened to choose the chest that time. Now it's going down the other path. Okay, so it's totally random as to which direction it chooses. And if it doesn't find anywhere to go, it's going to restart at the beginning. So we probably don't want to have any intersections, at least none that aren't, you know, a little bit specific about what direction to go down. Okay, so don't worry. We will handle this a little bit better. There we go. So let's get this chest off of here as well. So what we're going to want to do is be a little bit careful about intersections. Make sure that we are prepared for it, okay? So we're going to put the glass in here again. I might just break this guy for now, just so we don't actually have stuff being transported out. Good plan? Thought you guys might agree. We'll even put some of this stuff in here ready to sort, okay? So I'm probably going to need a few more sorting pipes. Let's get ready to make those. But what I do want to make sure I have is this thing pretty close to the top here, because we're going to want to be adding to it very, very shortly, as in pretty much right now. So I want to sort into my chests. Let's do this. So the last chest that I want it to go to, basically I want to have it sorting into, remember it's going to go to the first available inventory, right? So what I want to have happen is basically say, try and go into any one of these chests first. If the item matches what's already in the chest, it's going to land in there. So if a zombie brain, for example, landed in there, it would come up the pipe, it would find the first sorting pipe right here. Okay, and we'll have that connected, and it'll say, oh, this is a zombie brain, you belong right in there. Okay, great. If none of these items that are traveling through the pipe match what's in here, then it's going to continue on to the next chest, and check, and continue on to the next chest, and check, and continue on to the next chest, and check, etc., etc. So the very last chest in the line I want to be my miscellaneous junk chest. So what I'm thinking is have it go kind of around the room, maybe go through you know, all the different barrels here. We'll see about that in a moment. Maybe loop over to here and then go through all these chests, okay? So that's what's going to come up next, is we'll go through all these, loop through here, and then the very last chest in the line will probably be miscellaneous junk. So I think what I want to do is move miscellaneous junk from here to here. So let's do that. Come here, all you junk. Okay, that'll do. Miscellaneous junk can land right here, and then basically everything that's in here is stuff that wasn't properly sorted. Anytime you're building a sorting system, you're going to want to have an unsorted inventory type of deal. Something that's like, hey, I don't know what to do with this item, so I'm going to put it in this chest. That way, if you didn't account for something, or if you didn't consider something, or you just didn't have anywhere for it to land, now it's got a home. And it's going to be in that miscellaneous junk chest every time. That's the plan. Any item that we don't know what to do with goes in here. Any item that we do know what to do with will find its way into its proper home. Assuming, of course, that the inventory isn't completely full. If the inventory is completely full, then it's going to wind up having a problem, and it's probably going to wind up in miscellaneous junk. But we're going to try and avoid that by keeping an eye on the inventories. So basically, I'll come over here, check on this every now and then, and make sure stuff's good. All right, so to get items to go into these inventories here, I'm thinking what I'm going to want to do is the following. So you can insert into barrels from the back, and I think that's what we're going to wind up with. So let's use normal piping to come through here, because remember, we don't want to have any intersections. Any intersections that you have in these pipes will basically slow down the sorting network. Is it the end of the world? No, but it definitely helps to avoid it. Okay, so I'm going to go up like this, and then over here like this. Insert, 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 sorting. Oh boy, we have lots of intersections. How do we deal with this? Well, the nice thing about these pipes is you can kind of tell it which direction to go when it hits an intersection all the time. So if you want to make sure there's an intersection and every single time it hits that intersection, you want it to go a certain direction. Like say I wanted to, when it hits this intersection, always go to the left, hit it with a wrench or hammer. And you'll see that there's three block sides here that have like these darkened lines. Those are blocked off, preventing the item from going down that path. Continue clicking and you can change which side has that path. So if I always wanted it to go to the left, it would go this way. Cool. So off to the left, they will always go when they hit this intersection. That's kind of what we're going to do. Now, the pipes are pretty intelligent in that if there's no way for them to go down a path, they won't. So, for example, if I say when you hit this intersection, always go. Come on now, don't make a liar out of me. Up. Always go up. Always go left. All right, you know what? Because these are barrels, I don't actually need the sorting pipes. I can probably just use normal pipes. Because they're barrels, there's only one type of item that's going to go in anyway. And remember, it tries to hit the first inventory. So if it sees that stone, it's going to try and insert it in here, and the barrel's only going to accept stone. So we can do this. You ready? We'll say your path will always lead up, 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 left. We'll set this one to go down, 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 and down. Cool. Look at that, huh? Pretty nifty, right? And you're going to go... Well, yeah, you're probably going to go that way. You're going to go down, and you're going to go that way. That looks pretty good. You're going to be forced to go up. There we go. That looks pretty good. So item will come over here. It'll go up, 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 all the way around and sort its way down this way and then continue along this path. Cool. Once here, it's going to... I'm going to set this guy. I think if he's in white mode here, it prevents him from touching other inventories at all. So in that mode, it's only going to touch other pipes. It won't touch other inventories. We're going to come across here. You're probably saying, geez, Dire, you're making a mess of your floor. Don't worry, I have a solution. Sorting, 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 sorting. Item, item. Come across here and around, and then sorting, sorting, sorting. Regular items. And then finally, at the very end, our option is such that it's going to go that way. Now, because we have a connection possible here, I'm going to say that your direction will always go that way, and this direction will always go into the chest above. So that prevents these two from touching, okay? So the item should come all the way around. So if we put something in there that it doesn't know what to do with, it should eventually find its way to this miscellaneous junk chest. What do you say? We give it a try, okay? So we've got... transfer nodes. We're ready to give this a shot. So the first few things, so let's give it a stack of glass. That'll probably go into the miscellaneous junk chest. Gold, iron, copper, and redstone. And we'll kind of give this guy a shot to see what happens. Let's give it a good run over to here and get upstairs real quick. And then we should see these items traversing through the lines. But somewhere, there it is. It's trying to find a place to put glass, okay? Oh, there was already glass in here maybe, so that's good. Cool. Up and around it goes. See how it's going around and down. And then over to here. It's probably trying to find a place to put stuff. Oh, there it goes, glass again. Cool. So see how it's finding a place for glass to go? Beautiful. So it is a little bit slow, like I told you. And don't worry, there's a way we can increase the speed of this, which I'll show you in a moment here. But I'm just kind of keeping an eye on things for a moment to make sure everything works correctly. So again, it's trying to find a home. It's probably going to drop some gold in somewhere. Yeah, there it goes. Put some gold in, probably. Iron, we've got two at the very end. I think iron was next for the sorting. So let's give it a shot. Around it goes. Either iron or gold. 51 gold, 2 iron. 51 gold, 25 iron. See how cool that is? So it's kind of finding its way to the appropriate inventory. Again, not the most powerful sorting system. There are other pipes that are available from extra utilities pipes. Let's take a quick look at those. You've got a filter pipe, which allows you to specify at an intersection which direction things go based on what items they are. So you can say, hey, this item goes this way, this item goes that way. You've also got rationing pipes and energy pipes and crossover pipes and mod sorting pipes are kind of cool. And I'll probably wind up switching these guys out for mod sorting pipes because this is all my mod line of things, right? So let's consider doing that now. So what's a mod sorting pipe about? Got to take a sorting pipe and surround it with redstone. I can handle that. Let's break 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Redstone, we're good. So the mod sorting pipe, which is what I want to put here, 1, 2, 3, 4, does not have an interface, but it'll basically say anything from the mod that exists in this item. So it's like a sorting pipe, but it's going to say if it comes from the same mod, then it goes in here. So for example, zombie brains come from Thaumcraft. So they're going to automatically find their way into this inventory, just like they would with a sorting pipe, but any item that comes from Thaumcraft will probably also find its way into here. Pretty cool, right? Now, this might present a little bit of a problem as we get to the different ores and coppers and such, right? Because copper ore and that stuff comes from thermal expansion. So even though I want these ores to be here, so I should probably consider having these be last on the line. Yeah, because we really want it to hit this pipe first, come around, and then, yeah, I see. So let's consider that a little bit. Let's set it up so that... Tricky, but doable. Let's go back downstairs and straighten that out. That was something I hadn't considered. What, do I not have any more pipes left? Wow, I burned through those pretty quick, huh? So let's start, like, here, right? So we're gonna go here. Oh, there we go. That'll do. To here. Let's see how this looks. Alright, we're going to say go left first. Okay, and you're going to always go up. And you're going to always go that way. So that looks pretty good, right? So it'll come up here, go all the way around. Just gonna have to reverse all these, so give me a moment to reverse them. All right, so this should work a little bit better now. I just want to give it a quick test. One thing you're always going to want to do when building complex systems like this is give things a pretty good test. So let's give it something it shouldn't know anything about, which is the Christmas bucket, and then we'll put this stuff in here and we'll see how everything works out. Okay, so what we should see when we get up top is the Christmas bucket should be making its way around. Cool. So it has no idea what to do with a Christmas bucket. It's never seen one before. None of the chests have Christmas buckets in them. So it's going to filter it all the way around. It's going to come through here and eventually make its way into the miscellaneous junk chest. Perfect. Next up, we should have one of the ores. I think I threw copper in there. Nope, maybe not. What did I put in there? Probably should have paid a little better attention to what I was putting in there, but that's okay. It might have been a thermal expansion type thing. Oh, look at that. Little guy outside. All right, so that was the leadstone energy cells, I think. Cool. This one might be the Buildcraft landmarks. That looks pretty good. All right, I think we're in good shape here, guys. Oh, nope, it wound up in this miscellaneous junk. Oh, yeah, it was sorting pipes. Okay, didn't know what to do with them. Nothing else has sorting pipes. Let's make this guy handle sorting pipes. Cool. So that'll be the extra utilities chest as well. Technical BC factor AE, it'll also be extra utilities. All right, guys, so we have a pretty basic but functional sorting system. That was the landmarks. Nice. All right, I think we're in good shape. So let's see about speeding this up a little bit. One thing I'd like to do is craft some speed upgrades. These are listed in extra utilities right here. Okay, we're going to need a good amount of redstone for this. So good thing we've got a decent amount. Redstone blocks. Okay, we're also going to need a bit of gold. So let's see what a speed upgrade can do. All right, so for this, we're going to just need some gold nuggets. And we're going to try just the basic 4 speed upgrades. That's, you know, not bad at all. We should be able to handle that. I'm going to have to run back and forth again, aren't I? Yeah. Wish I had a portal gun or something. Unfortunately, not quite there yet. So if we put speed upgrades in this thing, it's going to search inventories much faster. We put them in the bottom slot here, and look how much faster it's searching for inventories. Without the speed upgrade, it takes a lot longer to get its way around. See? Slow. Fast. Awesome, right? So that's what we're going to wind up seeing here. I can demonstrate this a little better by, let's put you, and you. All right. And I probably should not have put the one thing that I really needed in there. You can go in there. All kinds of stuff, right? Should all mostly sort itself around. Let's see how fast the little redstone sparkles are going now. Look at that. Boom. Cruising, right? finding its way to those inventories much faster thanks to speed upgrades. Four of them is usually pretty good to get going. Not bad, right? Definitely not. Now, the one thing that I want to test to make sure that these mod sorting blocks are working is if that transfer node makes its way into the BC technical chest. Okay, so miscellaneous gadgets. Oh, cool. There it goes. Look at that. Nice. The transfer node did get there. And look, the bread, the redstone block, the stick, the lever, these things all made their way into this chest because I put a mod sorting block on there and worth filtering on the Minecraft mod, aka vanilla. So anything that's a vanilla item is going into there. So maybe I don't want to have a mod sorting block there, or at the very least, I don't want to have a hopper in there. Maybe hopper can go into miscellaneous junk. That sounds like a good plan. Yeah, definitely. All right, guys, so we've got a solid sorting system. I'm pretty pleased. Again, straightforward, basic, absolutely, but it's going to get the job done. Nice. All right, so the final piece is to make this place look a little bit nicer, and for that, I need a saw. A saw, there's a couple different ones you can make. Well, let's go with this one. This doesn't look too bad. So we're going to need a couple stone rods, which is just basically stone and stone, and a couple of sticks, and let's make them out of sapphire. That sound like a good plan? Yeah, we're going to need two of these guys. Cool. It's time to make some micro blocks. Let's do it, shall we? All right, so smooth stone 2. And shift click, I don't know if I mentioned this, shift click is the way you get one item at a time out of there instead of 2. And we're going to make a sapphire saw. Nice. Project Red. You can be Project Red. So the sapphire saw can be used to make the following. Micro parts. Okay, so let's say we wanted to cut our cobblestone in half. We can get some cobblestone slabs. 5 cobblestone cut in half gives us 10 slabs. And these slabs are basically half pieces of cobblestone. Cool, right? Now, micro parts are really neat in that you can place more than one micro part within the same block space. How awesome is that? Very. That's the answer, in case you were wondering. All right. Sapphire saw. We're going to slice this guy in half again. That gives us panels. One more time gives us covers. Cool. Covers can be used to place over top of anything that's interacts pretty well with this thing. Now, the one thing to note about covers is for these particular blocks, they will prevent them from connecting to each other. So if I place a cover in between two pipes, they will prevent them from connecting, just like when I was hitting it with the wrench. So if I were to, for example, place it here, we would guarantee they'd never connect, even though, you know, the wrench is preventing them from connecting, so it's really not necessary. But any mod that supports micro blocks like this, you're going to be able to have more than one block within the same space. So if you look at it, this looks like a completely flat and normal floor. But the reality is that we've got a micro block, this guy, Forge micro block, sitting on top of a micro part, which is the transfer pipe. Transfer pipes support Forge micro blocks, which allows you to place a pipe on top of them. Cool, right? Very, very awesome. So that's neat. Now, if you try to place this micro block between the chest and this thing here, we'll see that it's going to prevent them from connecting. That's not good. See how there's no connection there? Not good at all. We definitely want to have a connection, don't we? However, because chests do not take up a full block space, you're going to have these ugly holes in the floor if you don't do something. So let's do something, shall we? We're going to take these, put them in a square like so, and that'll give us some hollow cobblestone covers. These guys act just like the covers, except they have a hole in the middle. Nice, right? So if we put it up on like the chest here, we'll see that it has a nice little hole in the middle, which allows these blocks, the parts here, to travel through them. So if we have the hollow stone cover here, number one, it looks nice and flush and everything looks awesome. Number two, it still allows the connection to go through. So you can see there's like right there, you can see the connection occurring still. Yeah, so we still have the pipe going into the chest, even though we have a nice micro part here, making it all covered up and pretty looking. Nice, right? So let's see if I can get this in here. Sometimes it's hard to sneak your micro part right into the right slot once the block is already on top of it, but you'll get the hang of it after you play with them a little bit. Usually doing something like this really helps. You can also kind of see an outline of where the part's going to go. So you can see that's going to be flat on the floor, where that's going to be lifted up. So once you get the hang of it, it's not too hard to set up. Cool, right? Definitely. There we go. So once we've got all our micro part covers in place, we're ready to roll. So now we're making this place look a lot better. Come on, you. Get into this place. Where's these guys? It'll be easier if I place this one first, probably, like so. And then hook this guy up to this. Now I'm gonna need a couple more, so let's make them real quick. I'm gonna need one more set of these, and probably just a few more of these. And your saw does take damage over time, so you're gonna have to make a new one every so often or repair it somehow, etc., etc. Wrong spot for you. There we go. One, two, three. And I know, I'm being all fancy with cobblestone. I'm fully aware. But what are you gonna do? Right, so goes all the way around and eventually makes its way back to here. Cool, right? So we have a nice flat floored surface. Awesome. Gotta love it. Let's go outside and cover some stuff up as well, because we don't want it looking ugly from the outside either, so we're gonna have it here. And the nice thing about micro parts is you can have multiple blocks in one space, which basically means you're able to not only cover the outside, but the inside as well. There we are. Outside's covered. And inside. One, two, three. And brand new to the latest version of Thermal Expansion, micropart support. That's right, you can now cover your tubes and fluid ducts and item ducts and all that cool stuff with microparts as well. So we should be able to sneak this guy in here like so. Awesome. Looking good, right? Definitely. So I think our sorting system's complete. If I were to, for example, throw this saw in here, it should eventually make its way into this miscellaneous gadgets inventory because it's part of, oh no, that's a stone rod, part of Tinker's Construct. What do I have? That's a, there we go. Forge microparts. No, that's not Project Red either. Stone tool rod, huh? Well, I don't have anything, so it's probably just gonna eventually make its way to miscellaneous junk, I would guess. Yeah. Probably miscellaneous junk is where that should wind up eventually. Cool, guys. So we have a pretty nice setup here. And you know what I'm going to do? Remember I told you I had a way to make this look pretty later? It's finally here. Boom. Much nicer looking. Awesome. All right, guys. We have a sorting system. A basic one, I won't lie, but it's definitely going to work. Hooray! Oh, you know what? Because I took the stone tool rod out of here, it landed in this chest, because remember, a sorting pipe will land in a chest if there's nothing in it. So now this is the Project Red, at least for the exploration module of Project Red chest. Where was my Tinker's chest? There. Cool. We're going to make this the Forge microblocks part as well. So I'm going to go throw these microblocks in here, and they should sort their way over. And we can sort all this junk, and you can go away as well. Cool. We're cruising, guys. All right, we'll be right back. And what do you know, we've hit the old wrapping up point. So for now, this is Direwolf20 signing off. I do hope you guys enjoyed this episode. I'm pretty pleased with the fact that now we have a pretty basic sorting system. It's going to serve our purposes for a while, so we can rely on this thing to sort items for us all over the place. Cool. So without any further ado, we do have to wrap up the episode. We've hit the old wrapping up point. So this is Direwolf20 signing off. As always, take it easy.